Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to resolve the ENE.SYS driver error that's preventing a driver from loading on your Windows 10 or 11 PC. So this error usually occurs because Windows flags the ENE files as a vulnerable driver. So without wasting more time, let's jump right in. First, what you have to do is open your File Explorer. So go to the Start menu and search for File Explorer. Just simply click on the three dots at the top right and then select Options. Now in the Options tab, just simply go to the View tab, and under the View tab over here, you will have the option of Show Hidden Files, Folders, and Drivers. Just simply click on that, then click Apply, then hit OK. Now this will allow you to see all system files. So once you've done that, navigate to the C folder or this PC over here. Now once you're over here, this may locate the folder that contains the ENE file. So in most cases, the ENE file should be in Windows. Then simply go to System32. Now right over here, you simply search for the ENE file as you see right over here. So now once you find the file, what you would do is right-click on that file. Then just simply click on Rename and just simply add a letter or a number. Now the moment you do that, make sure that the ENESYS file is ahead of the number or the letter that you added, and then click anywhere on the screen and you will have this option right over here. Click on Yes. Now once the name is changed, this forces Windows to treat this as a different file. So now, if renaming the file doesn't completely resolve the issue, the next thing that you can do is temporarily disable the memory integrity. So what you have to do is simply open your Start menu, then simply type Core Isolation and open this option right over here. Now in the Core Isolation page, make sure in the Memory Integrity section this is turned off. So by default, it'll be turned on. Make sure to turn it off, as you can see right over here. So after you disable memory integrity, make sure to restart your computer, and then after the restart is complete, this should allow the driver to load properly once you have completed the task. So that's it. By following these simple steps, you should be able to fix the ENE.SYS driver error on your Windows 10 or 11 PC. So if you found this video helpful, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.